voice from the telescreen is still pouring forth its tale of prisoners and booty and slaughter. But the shouting outside had died down a little. The waiters were turning back to their work. One of them approached with a gin bottle. Winston, sitting in a blissful dream, paid no attention as his glass was filled up. He was not running or cheering any longer. He was back in the Ministry of Love, with everything forgiven, his soul white as snow. He was in the public dock, confessing everything, implicating everybody. He was walking down the white tiled corridor with the feeling of walking in sunlight and an armed guard at his back. The long hope for a bullet was entering his brain. He gazed up at the enormous face. 40 years it had taken him to learn what kind of smile was hidden beneath the dark mustache. Oh, cruel, needless misunderstanding. Oh, stubborn, self-willed exile from the loving breast. Two gent-scented tears trickled down the sides of his nose. But it was all right. Everything was all right. The struggle was finished. He had won the victory over himself. He loved Big Brother, Big Brother, Big Brother.